The single-seater cockpit has a volume of just 3.8 cubic meters and temperatures ranging from plus 40 degrees to minus 20 degrees Celsius. The cockpit of Solar Impulse is designed around the requirements of the longest flight, set to take 5 days and five nights across the Pacific. Within the cockpit are the flying controls, the flight display screens, the single seats, and the food supply for the pilot. Due to weight restrictions, the cockpit is not pressurized, and so there's also a complete oxygen supply and backup system to allow the pilot to breathe above 3,000 meters. In order to protect the pilot from the extreme cold temperatures at maximum altitude, the cockpit shell is made of high-density thermal insulation, developed by Biomaterial Science. At 8,500 meters above sea level, the air temperature can be as low as minus 40 degrees, and with this insulation, the cockpit temperature shouldn't drop below minus 20 degrees, the pilot still needing specific clothing to protect him at these temperatures.
The cockpit's easy to use because it's designed in an ergonomic manner. Everything's within reach. It offers him the possibility to be in the flight position and have access to all of the controls. It also offers him the flexibility to return into a resting position and be comfortable within the cockpit. The pilot can take any position from the flight position, which is 90 degrees, and allows him to control the airplane, and recline the seat all the way down to 180 degrees, where he can take the resting position. And he can also take any position in between if he wants to relax, monitor the controls, and the many positions allow him to do flight, relax, or to do exercise, resting, and to access the more difficult to reach areas within the cockpit.
The pilot's seat was developed by Lantal Textiles, including both ergonomic functions, such as an inflatable cushion to give the pilot back support, and safety functions, including a built-in parachute and life raft. Below the seat is a toilet that consists of removable bags, giving the pilot some level of relief during the long stages of flight.
The plane is designed in a way that, as Andre says, he designed his seat in a way that he can, as big as his yoga mat. So for yoga, one of the good things is that all you need is yourself and the space. And that space we have, you don't need any equipment. During the flight, when you're sitting for 5 days, five nights, you lose muscle atrophy, you lose strength, you lose blood circulation, joints get stiff, and yoga is exactly, this becomes absolute lifesaver to keep them completely active as one person is in walking and going around doing things. And yoga doesn't, it's just in that confined space, we have enough space to move every muscle, every part of the body, and keeping them in good shape.
The pilot stays in contact with the Mission Control Center using the Swisscom SATCOM system. The team there monitor the pilot's vital signs, such as his heart rate, and use alertness tests to check that he's coping with the mental fatigue from flying for so long. Rest breaks are possible due to Solar Impulse's monitoring and alerting system, an innovation from partner Altron that keeps the aircraft on a constant heading while the pilot takes 20-minute periods of sleep. If the pilot needs to tend to the controls, he's awoken using vibrating cuffs built into the arms of his flying suit.